Hello everyone! Today I'm going over my Amazon essentials. I have so many different categories for you. I have skincare, I have beauty, I have health, I have fitness, I have tech. And I'm going to show you guys everything that I cannot live without. And I got it all from Amazon. Alright, jumping straight into my video, I'm gonna do tech first because I'm most excited about tech. It's something that I like cannot live without. It makes my life easier, and I feel like if I share these tips with you guys, I think it would make your guys' lives easier as well. So I'm just gonna jump into the most basic and rudimentary thing of all, and I'm gonna talk about adapters. Like, I cannot live without adapters. I have a MacBook Pro, I also use Windows, I use Canon cameras, and everything requires adapters. So it sounds really lame for me to even be discussing this, but honestly, it makes a huge difference in my life at least. I use these HDMI to USB-C adapters all the time so I can play videos from my computer. I can show my family what I'm working on. I can hook it up onto bigger monitors, and sometimes I even use TVs as a monitor screen to get work done when I really want to get in and see my project in front of me. I used to design packaging this way for our products. I used to blow up my packaging on the screen, and then I could see really minutely where I could fill in and do different things with how our packaging is going to be made. There are adapters, and I can't find the one that I have, but I have an adapter that hooks my phone up onto the TV. And that's really cool too, because like if you want to just like sit down and like scroll on Instagram and show somebody something that you saw on Instagram, just hook it up really quickly. It's like a phone to an HDMI, and your HDMI cable can plug into your monitor or your TV. So that's really good too. So adapters, I will link my favorite adapters below. I have an adapter for everything in life, and trust me, it like really helps to have these around, so don't skimp out on having adapters. The second thing I wanted to show you guys was my Foreo, and this is a facial cleansing tool. Sorry, I have like soap residual on mine. Mine's the black one because I got the men's one, and it makes no difference whether you get the female or male one. It's the same thing. And I'll link mine below. I don't know if you can find this version because I think this might be like a year old, like a version old, but I really like getting the black one. I didn't want a pink one because it doesn't make sense in my bathroom. This looks really nice and sleek on my bathroom, so I got the black one, even though it's a men's one. But basically, it cleans the makeup off your face very easily. So if you want to be gentle with your face, you don't want to be scrubbing too much, lather your face up with some soap and you just rub this on your face like that. And there are like ways to use this. So like it's anti-aging. Like I think you go up with this. It's kind of like the Gua Sha tools that I showed you in my last tutorial. I'm going to talk about them here too. But yeah, this like really cleans your face out nicely. And I know it seems like a stupid step to be cleaning your face with a tool, but trust me, when you wear makeup, you want to make sure that you're not clogging your pores. And what the vibration does is it like loosens up the dirt and gets it out of the pores. So I like this. I really recommend it. If you can find a dupe for it on Amazon, go ahead and get the inexpensive dupe. You don't have to get Foreo. In fact, if I find a good dupe and it has good reviews, I will link it below. All right, next up in tech. And you guys are gonna think I'm crazy for suggesting this, but I think everybody needs to buy this. And it is a nail drill bit. Girl, let me tell you, when I bought a drill bit, it changed my life. You can get drill bits on Amazon for $10 to $20. You don't have to buy one that's $60. This was one of those. It's a brand called Aircee, and it's this nice pink color. You gotta plug it in, so it's not wireless, but the wire, it doesn't really affect me. And this particular tool, like I really like this drill, because what it does is I just go like this really close to my cuticle, and it cleans my nail up and shapes it. So either you can do this on your natural nail, or you can do this on like an acrylic nail. But I know I'm not the only one that has come back from the nail salon and like my nail is crooked. And you look at your nail artist and you're like, do I even say anything? Because I know they're gonna yell at me for saying anything. And then you finally muster up the courage and you're like, my nail's crooked. They'll be like, that's your finger crooked. And they don't even fix it, even after you say something about it. And so you gotta come home and you're looking at your hands and every single hour you get more and more angry. Like, they really messed up and I paid like $10 extra for like this shape and a nail art and stuff, and come home and you're unhappy with it. Well, if you have a nail drill bit, it takes 2 seconds, you just shave off one end and bam, it's not as crooked as it was before. Or let's say you have like a big hump and they didn't clean up properly near the cuticle, you can go over it and just quickly fix it. I have started doing my own acrylics at home. This was using dip powder. So if you guys wanna see a tutorial on how I do my nails at home, like, let me know in the comment section and I can do a quick tutorial for you guys the next time I have to fill in my nails. The next item is tech, but it's leaning towards the fitness arena. I really, really like Bose headphones. So I've had these Bose headphones for a very long time. My dad bought these for me and it doesn't have the model number on it or anything. So, hold on. I've never extended it out this far because my head's not that big. I mean, I have a big head, but like, you know what I mean. No, this doesn't have the number on it or anything, so I'll find it and I'll link it if it's still available, but these are on-ear Bose headphones, and Bose has the best sound quality out of any headphone that I've used. So I like these, I run with these, but the issue is it's on-ear, and when you run, it does get sweaty. So I come back home and I Lysol it and I clean it and everything. Now, my fiance, Sandeep, just bought these beautiful Bose headphones. These are the custom edition of these headphones. And even mine comes in a cool case too, but like, oh my God, look at These headphones are so nice. And the reason why I'm showing you guys these headphones is because it is noise canceling, folks. So this is a really nice, you turn it on and it automatically shuts off all the noise and it's like, so much peace. So people who have migraines like me, they need headphones like this. And I love the color. And let me show you. This goes completely over the ear. It fits over my entire ear. So I don't have to worry about it getting sweaty on my ear. It doesn't feel uncomfortable. It's easy to run with. They don't move off your head at all. And I even have my hair in the way. And they're not shaking off at all. So the fit is really nice, the design is really nice, and the sound quality is beyond anyone's expectations. I think Bose makes the best headphones, and my dad knows electronics like no one else, and he always recommends Bose to his friends and family. So, like I said, you can always get this headphone. This is a little bit cheaper than this version. This is one of the more expensive versions, but if you read the reviews on this particular headphone, it's beyond, like, it passes everyone's expectations and it always has like a really high rating. If you are like me and you love traveling, but you hate asking other people to take your picture, then I highly recommend you get a super light tripod for your phone. This can actually work as a selfie stick too. If you just shut these legs, you can hold it out like this. And of course this is expandable. And this right here is expandable as well. So you can get 360 movement with this thing right here, but I recommend something like this because it is a little bit heavier, which means it's sturdy. For instance, when I was in India, I shot my entire India vlog on my iPhone in 4K. So having a selfie stick like this really helps, but my issue was I broke my selfie stick on my way to India, so we couldn't use it. This part right here, it just snapped. So afterwards, I bought a higher quality selfie stick because the last thing you want to do is be boarding a plane, planning on filming an entire vlog on your phone and your stick breaks. Like, that was the worst luck. So if any of our footage was a little bit shaky, that's probably why. We didn't have any gimbals or selfie sticks or anything to like film on. But I think the video came out pretty nicely. If you're wondering what I'm talking about, I'll link it right here. I went to India in December to do my wedding shopping. It was a lot of fun. I got this case from a company called Rockform and it was gifted to me, but I swear to you, I would have bought this with my own money 10 times over because I just really like how sturdy it is. I have dropped my phone a million times and nothing has happened to it because this case has saved me. I don't even have a screen protector or anything like that. And the best part about this case is it has a magnet on the back. So when I am in Blacksburg, Virginia with my fiance Sandeep, I'm living in this apartment by myself. He's off getting his PhD on and I'm left to like hang out by myself, do my own stuff for the company, and I like to cook a lot too. So I snap this onto the vent hood above our stove. And I like watch TV and I watch cooking lessons or like I'll catch up on Vanderpump Rules and stuff like that. And you'll be surprised how many things magnets work on. So I'm always like finding a place to like prop my phone up with this magnet. All right, so that's it for the pure tech stuff. And now I'm gonna move towards the beauty stuff because now I have some tech that helps beauty. This is my favorite face steamer. I recommend this 1,000 times over because I think steaming your face is great for your health. If you have allergies, if you're sick, it helps open up your nasal passageway so you can breathe better. But in terms of skincare, it's actually really good for your skin as well. So what I'll like to do is I'll put on some essence or a serum on my face and I'll steam this on my face. And that heat lets that serum penetrate my skin and my pores open up. So it allows all my skincare to go into my skin. It also makes me look a lot more refreshed and awake after I do it. Sometimes if my makeup isn't applied on nicely and I'm looking cakey because I have like really dry skin, I'll just turn this on for a second and let the steam hit my face. It's kind of like the Evian spray for your face, but like better because this actually works better. That one you're like spritzing on your face and you're like have droplets of water all over your face. Like this is actually a steam and it just like makes my makeup look better. But like, don't do it for too long. You don't want to put makeup into your pores or anything like that. I literally just do this for like 3 seconds on like the worst day of makeup that I've ever had because we all have those guys. That leads into face masks. I love using face masks. I wish I had the brand that I like with me right now, but I'll link them. And I actually found out about it when I was in Hong Kong doing some research on manufacturing facilities for Sahi Cosmetics. It's called MediHeal. So it's Korea's number one brand. And I think I met the factory that makes their masks and they are just really advanced. So I really like MediHeal. There's a lot of crap masks on Amazon. So you can find masks that are cheaper. This is $2 a mask. I think it's well worth it because it actually works on your skin. So I'll link the MediHeal masks that I recommend to you guys. Like I said, I was in Hong Kong when I found out about them and I have been using them ever since. So it's been like 3 years since I have been using that brand. The next skincare product is again these Gua Sha tools that I've talked about. I won't talk about it anymore. There's these rose quartz tools that you use for anti-aging and it's basically like skin exercising. And I'll link the tutorial for that right now and go watch that if you want. But yeah, I got those off Amazon and I highly recommend them. All right, so that's it for skincare. I'm gonna kind of segue into makeup at this point because some of this stuff is skincare infused and it is, surprise, surprise, Sahi Cosmetics. This is our Skin Perfecting Elixir Foundation. It has ceramide and peptides in it. So it's a really good anti-aging formula. Plus it has SPF 50 plus. Technically, when I ran the test with my factories, the SPF came out to 87, but for legal reasons, we have to always like say it's 50 plus because of how the FDA is structured here. So anyways, it's 50 plus and has an airless pump inside of it. So as you pump, there's a plate here that goes up and up and up and up and up, and you use every single last drop that's within the bottle. And that's why our foundation is bomb.com. You need to check it out. If you guys need to know how to match your shade, I'll link that, above here. I'll link that video up here so you guys can check it out. But like this foundation is really, really good and it's FDA registered. The next thing I wanna talk about was in FabFitFun. It's our Mystic Primer Serum. It has niacinamide, sodium hyaluronate. It has a gel form consistency. You guys have seen me use it in a bunch of our videos. And the other thing that's on Amazon is our Diamond Treatment Lip Balm. And this guy has jojoba oil and shea butter. And they're both sourced from Argentina and France. So it's really expensive stuff. So use a little bit, it'll go a long ways. I know you're thinking who's gonna get a lip balm for $18, but trust me, if you see our Amazon, like a lot of people got the lip balm. And a lot of people swear by it. It's just that you need to know that it is, like, not Burt's Bees. It's really good quality ingredients. If you guys want Burt's Bees, like, lip balm, waxy stuff, like, go ahead, do your thing, girl. But this is, like, the next step up, which is expensive ingredients. So that's why the price point's where it's at. All right, and then the next thing that I want to talk about, our eyeshadows, as you guys know, they were part of Ipsy, so a lot of people buy our eyeshadows off Amazon too. I'll link those below. We have a lot of reviews on them, so, and if you've bought it off Amazon, haven't left a review, please go leave a review. That means the world to us. The next thing I want to talk about is a fiber wax for your hair. This is from Old Spice, and it smells so good. Like, I know it's for guys, but, oh, it smells so good. Guys, listen, I just take a little bit of this and I go like this for my flyaways because I have a lot and I have it in my hair right now. And I just want to show you, look at the movement. It's not making my hair at all crispy, but it put my flyaways down, which is amazing. And I have like these edges here too. So usually I'll show you. I just put a little bit on my finger and then don't drop the cap. And I rub it on my fingers, kind of heat it up, and then I just go like this, and I pat my flyaways down. Well, these are my edges. Like that, that's it. And it doesn't make your hair dirty the next day. You don't feel crunchy or anything like that. That's why I'm recommending this product to you, guys. So you don't need to worry about, oh, I have to wash my hair the next day when I use this wax. No, like you can use it day after day after day, and it's not gonna make your hair look or feel gunky. It's just, you know, it just puts your hair in the right place, but it doesn't like build up. And I think that's why they made it for men, is because it doesn't build up, and guys don't, they're not the most cleanest species of all. So anyways, so I want to tell you guys one of the biggest secrets that I have, and this is like, this is a product that I have been using for years, and to be honest with you, every time I use this product, people like hate that my lashes look this good, and like people go out of their way to be like, oh, I could never wear fake eyelashes, like that's why I didn't wear any eyelashes today. I'm like, don't be self-conscious, girl, it's totally cool, you don't have to wear false lashes, but like this is what that product makes people do, and it is this brand right here. They're faux mink. Don't buy real mink, guys. Like, God knows what they do to the animals. They're faux mink, and the brand is called Befalan, and this PH, Befalan. I mean, I'm gonna link it anyways. And here's a used one, so you guys can see. And I used these on my last tutorial, so I can insert a picture right here, so you can see how it looks on my eyes. I think we're good. Okay. So yeah, these are the best lashes that I've ever bought off Amazon, and it came in a pack of three. So next I want to move into fitness because I got a lot of fitness stuff here. As you guys know, I'm getting married sometime this year. Hopefully, thank you so much, Sarah Avenor. Please go away. So I have been trying to get fit, and fitness is like a never-ending goal for me. It's been like that ever since college, man. I'm just like, I should give up at this point, but no, I'm not going to. I'm going to keep working out. I'm still going to try and be the best that I can be. So one of the things I wanted to recommend is this foam roller, because if you start working out heavy and your body is starting to hurt, you definitely need a foam roller to roll your muscles out. Yesterday I just went running in the basement. We have a treadmill, and I ran 20 minutes, and on the 20th minute, my calf just like shriveled up, something snapped. I don't know what happened. So like even today, it's been hard for me to put pressure on my right calf. And that's because I didn't stretch enough before I worked out. So, I mean, I should be telling myself this, but I highly suggest getting a foam roller, roll your body out after you work that part out, like a day after, 2 days after. I like to use this to crack my back too. So I'll like roll on it and I'll go, and then my entire back cracks. And I love doing that. I really recommend Menduka yoga mats. This is their traveler yoga mat, and it's in this navy blue color. And if you can tell, it's a little shimmery. And I just like absolutely love that. Like, this yoga mat was made for me, guys. And it's a really, really thin rubber one. It's a eco one, so I'm pretty sure it's made out of like sustainable rubber. But I really like this yoga mat. Got off of Amazon for $35, and I highly recommend it. You go. Quiet. Quiet. Meow. Meow. All right, so one of the reasons why I recommend having a small yoga mat is because, like, look at how I have it folded up, guys. Like, it's so easy for me to fold this up and put this into my gym bag. I go back and forth between Virginia and Michigan, and this comes with me every single time. So it's easy to travel with. And most importantly, whenever I go to Lifetime Fitness here, I pull off one of their yoga mats and I lay them down and I put this on top. So it gives me better grip. I don't have to be sweating on someone else's sweaty mat. And I don't know, it just makes me feel a lot more comfortable having my own mat with me. So that's why I recommend this guy. To go along with that yoga mat, one of my favorite Bikram yoga towels is this guy. Look at how pretty it is. It's so pretty. Oh, I just love the colors. Every time I take this to Bikram yoga, everyone looks at my mat. They're like, where did she get this from? And the brand's right here too. It's called Zapita. And I got it from Amazon, and everybody stares at my mat. So it's one of those microfiber towels, and I just wash it so it smells like laundry, and it smells really, really delicious. But yeah, I like to wet this in the beginning a little bit because my feet, I don't sweat. Like, I don't have sweat on my hands and feet. I'm such a weird person. I think it's because I was on Accutane for like 3 regimens, so now I just don't sweat on my hands and feet. I spray it a little bit with water in the beginning, and then once we start doing yoga, I start to sweat and I'm good to go. But yeah, I really recommend getting this yoga mat because it's so pretty and everybody likes your yoga mat, so maybe they'll become friends with you. The other thing I really like is this Thermoflask water bottle. It keeps my water so cold. Pretty much you can put water and ice in it in the morning and I'll still be cold by nighttime. Me, like, I drink a lot of water, so that's why the cap is off. I'm just like easy access. I don't want to. And this bottle is 24 ounces, so it's a pretty good amount. Now, I bought Sandeep, my fiance, a Simple Modern water bottle, and I'll put it right here. Put a picture up right here because it's so cool. I got it customized on Amazon. I got his name on it and it's everything that he would want, but that's a 32 ounce water bottle. He is like 6 foot something. I think it's 6'1" or 6'. He's super tall anyways. He's like a big boned character. So he drinks a lot of water. So for him, getting like a small 16 ounce water bottle, it just doesn't mean anything. So we got him a 32 ounce. The only caveat to that is it doesn't fit into the cup holder of your car. I think this guy still does fit into most cup holders, the 26 ounce of Thermoflask. So I'll link both of them in the description box below. You guys can check them out. But Simple Modern, I really like the customization feature. So it's a really nice gift if you want to give to somebody or if you just want to gift it to yourself. Now, on those same lines of running, something that really bothers me is when I get like Charlie horses in my legs, and that happens to me a lot, like especially when I'm sleeping. And usually that's indicative of not having enough electrolytes in your body, and sometimes I'll wake up really fatigued. And I don't know if I'm the only person that does this, but like, I'll wake up and I'll just feel like I don't have energy and my tongue just feels like it's big. I don't know, this happens to anemic people too. Like, your tongue feels big and swollen and you're like really thirsty all the time, and no matter how much water you drink, it's not enough. Well, then that means you need electrolytes. And this is the best brand of electrolytes. My friend recommended this on her Instagram and I went off and got it, and I'm so glad that I did. This is called the Liquid IV Hydration Multiplier, and this is like probably one of the strongest electrolytes I've ever had. I've had other ones before and I can link a couple other ones too, but this is by far the best for people that are trying to get fit and you are actively running every single day or you're actively working out in some capacity. The last thing I want to talk about is coffee, because I have coffee every single morning, but I'm trying to stay fit. And I realize that coffee creamers have a lot of additives inside of it. Additives have really low pH and your body doesn't know how to digest these additives. So what happens is your body just stores it on top of your fat storage. And since it has a low pH, your body also comes and stores water to neutralize all those additives because it doesn't know what to do with that junk that you're putting in your body. So you end up gaining water weight. So I didn't know coffee creamer was making me so puffy until I stopped drinking coffee creamer. And instead now, I make a double shot espresso every single morning and I make it into a latte with 2% milk. and I add 1 tablespoon of these syrups in. And I got these syrups off of Amazon, and I feel like this has made a drastic change in my overall puffiness that I've seen in my face and on my stomach too. So this one is the brown sugar cinnamon one, and it tastes kind of like a PSL that you could have year round. Like, that's the best way that I could explain it. Because of the cinnamon, it reminds me of a pumpkin spice latte, but without the pumpkin-y flavoring. And this one actually tastes like butterscotch. So I at most will put a tablespoon, and I broke the lid off of this one. That's why it's like all messed up. But anyways, I'll put a tablespoon inside of a latte, and my lattes are around like 16 ounces. So it's like a grande with 1 tablespoon of syrup, which is a lot less than what Starbucks would do. But I'm getting used to not having my coffee as sweet. And the fact that these are flavored so nicely, it makes it easier for me to sacrifice getting that sweet, sweet flavor in the morning. The very last thing I wanted to show you guys was some jewelry, some accessories, and got these really cute climber earrings. And they have these like 3-diamond kind of look to it. And it's just like a little string right here. You plug it into your ear that way, and it sits like this. I only have 1 piercing, but this is a way that I kind of like look like I have 3 piercings. So every time I wear these, I get compliments on it. So I thought I would include this in this little Amazon Essentials, because people just really like that earring set. And the other thing I want to tell you guys is Amazon has a lot of Indian jewelry, guys. This set was just $20 on Amazon, and it's high quality. I really like this set. Even if you're not Indian, like, buy this set, wear it at home, do a photo shoot, because I think it's so pretty. Everyone needs to have it in their life. And if you think about it, $20 on Amazon, they're giving Amazon probably a 40% cut. Then the cost of exporting the products from India, bringing it over here, they're probably only making like $5 on this set. Like, for me, I think $20 is a totally reasonable price, especially because it's such a beautiful set and the finishing is really nice too. So definitely check out Amazon for your Indian jewels, guys. That about wraps it all up, guys. Thank you so much for watching my Amazon Essentials. This is all that I have been using currently. Like, I know about these products because I'm using them every single day. I'm sure if I thought about it harder, I could find more products that I could recommend to you guys. But the point of this is just to show you guys what I'm using every single day that is an essential. So there are some more Amazon Essentials that I am going to include in my YouTube setup video, and that I haven't put on here, even though I use it every single day. I just don't know if anybody else would use it every single day, unless if you're a YouTuber. So that video is gonna come separate, and that'll have some separate recommendations too. But this video was just about everyday items that I feel like everybody could use and everybody would enjoy if they had it at home too. So thank you guys so much for watching. It's been a blast shopping and sharing these things with you. And if this video goes well, I hope it goes well, then I will go out and buy more stuff off Amazon. Every day we have a package coming home, and it's either my dad buying electronics or me buying some junk like this. And my mom gets so mad. She's like, when are you guys gonna stop buying stuff off of Amazon? Like, we've probably spent over $200,000 just on Amazon with like food, electronics. I mean, it's crazy. We go ham on Amazon. I mean, Amazon should probably pay me for buying stuff from them at this point. But regardless, thank you guys so much for watching this haul. I hope you enjoyed it. And please subscribe to this video and give it a like. I know it's not going to mean much to you if you do it, but it's going to mean the world to me if you guys subscribe and like this video, because I just need a little bit of encouragement. I'm new at this, and I would really, really appreciate if you guys showed me some encouragement, enthusiastically hit that like button and subscribe, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye.